Hey guys, in today's video, we're gonna show you the ultimate pentatonic warm-up drill and watch Jazz Moss here go beast mode. We'll see you inside the video. Hey guys, it's James here, and I'm here with another episode of our Real World Bass Heroes podcast interview series. And I've got special guest Jazz Moss back again. How are you doing, Jazz?
I'm good, James. Thanks for having me.
Now, one thing I love to ask every single bass player which comes on this show is, what are their warm-up drills? I discover every bass player has a slightly different set of warm-up drills. So that's what we're going to cover with Jazz today. So Jazz, what is the drill that you've got for us today?
So I call this drill the pentatonic zigzag exercise. I know you call it something slightly different, but essentially what we're going to be doing is taking the pentatonic scale. You can take the major or minor pentatonic scale, and we're going to be going up the neck and back down again in different shapes.
So first of all, let's hear the ultimate warm-up drill in action so you know what it sounds like. So first off, we're going to learn the pentatonic bass drill. Then I'm going to challenge Jazz Moss to go beast mode and show you what this drill can really do. Just before we get going, we want you to note there's a completely free PDF that comes with this video, so you can see everything we're discussing in these pentatonic warm-up drills written out in standard notation and tab. This is really going to accelerate your learning of this particular drill. So make sure you grab that free PDF. There's a link in the description below. So first of all, Jazz, let's just back up a little bit. Why is this drill really important, and how can it really help benefit a student's bass playing?
Well, I think the pentatonic scale, after you've learnt your major scales and your minor scales, the pentatonic scale is probably the next scale on the list to learn. It's one of the most useful scales in all of Western music, and there's so many bass lines that use this scale. And you can use this scale to create your own bass lines, and kind of like another side benefit as well, is this is going to be a great technique exercise, specifically for the left hand for position shifting.
Now, there's a little bit of a twist with this lesson, isn't there, Jazz? Now, when I would teach a drill like this, I would always teach it using the one finger per fret technique. But you're going to teach it using a very slightly different technique, and it's really important to understand this. What's that technique?
So this technique, I think you call it the 4/3 technique.
Correct.
And I call it the Simandl technique. Now it's the same, just different names. So what this means is I'm going to be primarily using my first and fourth finger to play this exercise.
So what's super interesting about this is the Simandl technique normally uses the first, second and fourth finger. So the third and fourth fingers work as a unit. Simandl technique or 4/3, exactly the same thing here. But Jazz is choosing to take this a step further and just limit himself to his first and his fourth fingers, which makes the position shifting really interesting and ultimately can help you build your speed. So let's discover how this works. So Jazz, quickly talk us through the five shapes.
So the five shapes, we're going to be using the E minor pentatonic scale, and we're going to start with the open string position here. So we have E, G, and then I'm going to shift a little bit and use my first finger, open A, and then first finger on the second fret B, D, E, G, A. That's the first shape.
So practice that shape to begin with, coming up and down. Now move us on to the second shape. What are you playing?
So yeah, you would go up the first shape like we just did, and then you're going to go down the next shape. So I'm going to put my fourth finger on the B, first, fourth, first, fourth, first, fourth, first. And I'm going down the E minor pentatonic.
So what you're going to discover is Jazz is going up one shape and then down the next. So now you've got the concept, we're going up one shape and then down the next. Why don't you take us up pattern number three and down pattern number four? Show us how that works.
Okay, so pattern number three starts on the A here. We're going to go first finger, fourth finger, D, E, G, A, B, D. And this is why it's great for position shifting. You're gonna have to position shift with the fourth finger up, and then we're gonna go down the fourth shape and land back on the B.
So we've covered shape number 1, 2, 3, and 4. What's the final shape that we need to learn?
And the final shape is right up here on the dusty end of the neck. We're gonna go D, E, G, A, B, D, E, and finally the G on the 12th fret.
So you've learnt all 5 shapes, Jazz. Mm-hmm. What is the next stage?
So the next stage is just trying to put these shapes together. And what I'd recommend is actually doing it out of time first, and then maybe putting on a metronome at say 60 or 70 or 80 BPM, and then trying to play up to the 12th fret and then back down the shapes again to the open E.
So can you slowly take this apart and just keep going for us?
Yeah, sure. So. And then position 3, or shape 3. Shift to 4. Then 5. And then you would go back down the shape. So you would go down 5. And then up 4. So it's kind of like the opposite.
Now, don't forget, all of this is written out in the PDF which comes with this lesson. One quick tip from me here is you could also learn each shape ascending and descending in isolation too. If you're finding this a little bit overwhelming, that would be a great precursory, if that's a word, exercise to learning this drill. Cool. Is precursory a word?
Precursory. I'd have to look it up. I think it is now.
So guys, is precursory a word? Let us know in the comments below. So what I'm dying to hear now is, what does this exercise sound like in context? So pick a tempo, Jazz, and let's try it with the drums. What tempo should we choose?
Let's choose 85. We're going to do 85 BPM, and we're going to do eighth notes. Let's try it.
Right at the beginning of this lesson, I promised you I was going to get Jazz to go beast mode. So my challenge for him right now, if he's going to accept it, is to play that at 16th notes. So 85 beats per minute with 16th notes. Are you up for it?
Let's give it a go.
Here goes.
One time.
Oh man, that was incredible. Top work. I admire you. I can see how tricky that is. The cool thing about this, and this is why I want you to try it, is using that first and the fourth finger. Because what I've learned from this is it gives you so many usable real world fingering patterns, which you wouldn't necessarily get if you were just doing the typical one finger per fret technique. So check it out, give it a shot. So guys, that's it for today's video. I want to say a massive thank you to Jazz.
Thank you, James.
Now, if you'd like to work with Jazz, Jazz is one of our E-Bass Guitar VIP coaches. So if you'd like to study with him and learn how to go beast mode too, you can head over to ebassguitar.com/VIP and apply to work with him there. So that's it for today, guys. If you need any help with your bass playing, head over to ebassguitar.com. There's a full step-by-step program ready and waiting for you right there. What's even better is you can take it for a test drive completely free for 14 days. There's a cheeky link in the description below. That's it for now. We will catch you next time.